G'day guys, Mozzie here. Welcome back to Mozzie Plays Minecraft, episode number 54. And I just remembered that the end of last episode we re-initiated the villager breeder, and this has been going for quite some time because I've been over in the big hole digging. So there's actually probably merit to turn this off at the moment. So I think that's what we're going to do. If we go around the corner here, we should see a bunch of villagers. There was already heaps here, but yeah, there's definitely more in there, I think. It's about a hundred or so in there at the moment. And still I got about a 50 over here. And these guys will all have to ship out to the iron farm very soon. And of course that hasn't been making any iron because it's sort of broken at the moment. That was one thing that I really wanted to try and fix this episode. I've been playing around with some ideas for iron farms. I kind of want to make a more efficient iron farm that produces more iron. I was watching some videos there by Tango Tech, so I thought I might come up with an idea. But first I want to just show you what I've been doing over in the big hole over here. Alright, let's go down and take a look. So, what I've done is covered the entire floor with slabs. And the reason I did this was to reduce some of the mob spawning that was happening down here. Namely the slimes, actually. Spiders and stuff I'm not extremely worried about, but I definitely wanted to stop the slimes from spawning in here so often. Because what was happening is I was down here and there was heaps of slimes spawning and none was spawning at the top where my killing chambers are. But what you might notice also is that I've finally cleared out this huge section of lava that was here. It was mostly obsidian, and it was taking so long to get rid of it, I decided not to use water with it, and just place blocks and break them to get rid of the lava. And that was a good option, I think, because it took not very long to get that out. But the outer perimeter is all finished as well. Well, when I say finished, it's not quite finished. It's the first stage, I guess you would call it. But it's starting to look really, really roomy. And of course, as we mentioned before, this is just one of four columns of storage space that are going to be in here. So what I've started to do now is do a second level, and I'm going to follow that contour all the way around again and get rid of all that stuff, and then probably have a third level where I do the same, get rid of all the contour. I think I might want to actually make a bit of a dome roof. I think they look really cool. I know they're really hard to make, but I think that would be really cool. So we'll see how we go. We'll probably leave it like this for a while with the straight sides before I start... There's a witch up there. Before I start sort of hollowing out the side, I think we'll just go straight up for a little while. I made it so that this is the closest point, and the furthest away point's going to be in the middle up there somewhere. So that is the idea, but yeah, putting all these slabs down I think will be good in the short term. They're only temporary. We will pull them up again later, I think, and put down a different floor covering. I think. We might even leave the slabs there, but yeah, we've got to work out some more lighting and get rid of all this random glowstone and a few things like that. And this is, of course, where I trialed the first size, the first section of walkways, which I'm leaving here because I need to copy some of the ideas that I had on this. And, of course, we're still getting some mobs spawning around the area there, but they're not too bad, so... They shouldn't cause us too many problems. Alright, but what I want to do now is go and have a look at the iron farm and see if we can work out whether we can make a new iron farm over there. Okay guys, so here we are at the iron farm, and you might already notice something wrong here. Our big iron golem mascot has a big chunk cut out of the middle. I've been working pretty hard here. You can also see we've got some glass in the floor here. Been working pretty hard for quite some time now to prepare this iron farm to be upgraded. And if we look down here, more glass. All the water is gone. All the villagers are gone. They actually died. There was some kind of a zombie siege, I think, and one of the zombies found its way in somehow. I'm still not sure how he got in. And transformed all the villagers to zombies. And so I thought, well, that's a sign. I've got to just tear this whole thing down and start with a new one right now. So that's what I've been doing for the past few hours, probably about 4 or 5 hours now. And What I've been doing is actually creating an underground version of one of Tango Tech's farms, and I spoke about him in the intro. He's got quite a few farms, well known for his iron farms. The latest one he's got out is the Iron Titan, and I followed the tutorial on that and thought that would probably be a good option for me. However, I didn't really want to go and build a crazy one like he's got. He had a 64 village version, and also a 32. I've actually opted for a slightly smaller 16 village version, and I'm not sure whether this will work or not. I assume it uses the same sort of mechanics that his 64 village version does, and providing I get all of the spacing and positioning correct, it should work in theory. So what we're going to be doing here is actually overlapping 16 villages in this one tiny little area. This is the center point where all the villages will be centered, and then all this area with the polished diorite and all of the stone here, that'll all be dug out and be a water stream, and that will be the area where the golems spawn. We'll also have to expand out that way by 8 blocks as well. And in this slabbed area is going to be 11 doors per row, and we've got 16 rows, and we've got two sides. So yeah, that's quite a few doors, but this whole process is very tricky to get right, especially when you're building it underground. So Tango Tech's tutorial is for a farm in the sky, which would be a lot easier than what I'm doing right now. That's why I opted to do a 16 villager version, 16 village version, I should say, because it's going to be easier to do it underground than some of the larger ones. So what we're looking at here is this is sky access all the way up. You have to have these sky access points for various doors that we'll be placing. There's specific spacing in between this sky access and the next lot, which I'm just building now, and that's where I ran into our iron golem mascot, which is going to have to be torn down, unfortunately. My plan is to rebuild him bigger and better though, and maybe I'd do a couple of them, so he won't be gone for long, hopefully. And then over here we've got another lot of sky access here. I've gone up through the water in that section. That's the part on the grass that we walked past before. And then we went all the way down here, and this is the rest of the setup. We've got another one here which took a very long time, all the way to the top of the mountain. And this one here, also most of the way to the top of the mountain. We've got another one right here, which went all the way up as well. And one last guy all the way at the end here, which is another sky access here. So these are all for the doors that are going to be placed on these bits of polished diorite. So the doors to be registered as a valid house need sunlight. You probably all are aware of that. And you have to have uneven amounts of sunlight and shadow on either side of the door. So for example, if we were to place a door here, 5 blocks in this direction and 5 blocks in this direction are checked, and if one of them has less sunlight or less shadow than the other, then it can determine that it's actually a village house. I'll go into that a bit later on when we get to placing the doors, but I wanted to show you what we're doing. So essentially this whole area here will be full of water, and the iron golems will sink right down to the middle, and then we're going to have some way, I'm not sure what we're going to do yet, but some way of getting down and harvesting all that iron. We might even have an automatic system bring it up to the surface for us with a minecart or something, but that is the plan. And this farm is going to be 16 times more efficient than my last farm that I had here, and I think that's more than enough iron for my little projects that I carry out, considering that so far this is the old iron chest right here. I've been putting heaps of other rubbish in there at the moment, but considering that the iron farm that we had before had enough iron in it to create all of my contraptions thus far, means that this 16 village version should more than enough be able to cope with what we're trying to do. So I've still got more to do here. I need to finish off this central bit here. We've got to go all the way to the top of the mountain again, pretty much, run some more glass across here as well, and open this up to sky. Once this one is done, we're actually about ready to start placing doors. We need to get some villages in, of course. We need a few villages in here and a few villages over in the middle there somewhere. and I've still got to work out how I'm going to do that. Probably just going to use drop shafts from the top and drop them down onto a slime block or something, but we'll see how that goes as we travel along. Hopefully I'll have some kind of progress for you. I don't know if we're going to get this whole thing done by this episode, but we might, so we'll see how we go. Well, here comes one of our villagers. He's heading down. Just made the holding cells for all the villagers to sit in, and hopefully he'll go in and around, and an empty cart will come back out, which it did. Excellent. So I pretty much need to just get about 20 or so villagers in this first little hole that I've made. Let's just go have a quick look what I've done here. This is just a little ejection system. So the guy's just right across here. Powers this rail, which powers this, activator rail. Land on here, and then fall down the hole. Got a slime block down there to stop them taking damage. And we need to get about 20 of these guys down there. So I'm going to stand here for a little while and wait for it to sort of fill up. And once it's sort of full, I thought I saw a creeper there. Once it's full, I've got a second one that I have to do on the other side. Let's have a look. This one is in a very inconvenient spot. It's actually, where's all my sound? I can't hear anything. Inconvenient spot, it is right here. So we're going to have to move this portal, which I was going to do anyway. I was going to do that a long time ago, actually, but we will have to move that portal. And then we get villagers into there, and then the final spot for some more villagers is... let's go through the wall here. All the way out the back here in our chunk-loaded section. That little guy right there. Oh, there's a witch. Where are you, witch? Oh, and there's a baby zombie as well. Where is he? That's the last one I've got to do with that little bit of sand on top. Need to put some more villagers down there too. So, might take a little while, and when they're all in, we'll come back and see what it looks like. Okay guys, there we go. So this cell, as far as I can tell, has just enough villagers in it. I think there's somewhere around the 24-25 mark. So we need to have more than 20, that's for sure. So next I need to wrap this rail line around the corner here and fill up this next section. And I'm going to do that, and then I'll show you how I made this little ejection system, because there are some little tricks to it. Okay guys, so here's the ejection system that I've been using. This is now hooked up on that second position. And these things are a little bit glitchy at the moment. We're still in 1.8.1 at the moment. I haven't updated for quite some time. But these activator rails don't always eject your entities where you would expect. I think they are working on it at the moment. However, this one here, what we have to do is make sure that the position that we want it to eject to is towards the east. So, so far, the best I can do is work out that if you have the ejection position at the east, then it will work most of the time. Another tip I'll give you is that if you put a detector rail instead of just powering that, it seems to work better as well. If this is just powered, like those rails there are powered, this tends to eject in front of itself or behind itself or just in really odd areas. So by doing it this way, it sees the next available spot as right here, lands on the pressure plate, which pushes the piston out and pushes the villager down into the hole. So it does work quite well. It did have a little bit of tweaking. If you try and put anything above this spot here, it won't work. It looks like it searches for air spaces here, I guess. I'm not sure if it does or not. There we go. I'm not sure if it does or not, but that's what I feel like it does. And yeah, that's probably why if you put something above there, it won't actually work. The villager will actually get spat out somewhere on the track and get picked up immediately and keep going. Alright, so there's two villagers in there at the moment. Whoops, screenshot. Two villagers in there at the moment. We just got to let that add up a little bit further, and then once that's up to about 21, 22, we will move on to the next little cell. All right, well, this should be just about the last villager that I need, I think. So we're going to turn these powered rails off. And I've already set up this minecart track all the way to the very end here, where our final drop-off point is. Here comes the minecart back again. Let's go make sure that that's all good. So this is the final of three holding cells that hold villagers. And there's a couple down there. Let's see. About five. That's how we want. Alright, so next I'm just going to block that off. And we'll leave this all here for the moment, because it won't matter too much if it's all still here for the moment. Eventually we'll probably decommission this rail, because I no longer have to worry about villagers being killed in here, because they're all contained now. So our reject villagers will have to work out another way to get rid of them. Now, this is where some of them are here. I need to get rid of those blocks and replace them with glass. So let's go down and have a quick little look, because we're very close to about to put our doors down. And to put the doors down, I'm actually going to be using a NBT viewer, which will help me make sure that I don't make any mistakes. All it does is just access the data from the save file, and it just lets me have that open and check it while I'm making the villages. The only reason to do that is because this takes quite a long time to make the stackable villages, and I don't want to screw it up and then have to redo it all over again, because it already took more than long enough to build this thing. So there we go. There's this one lot there. We got 28. Second lot here. Got 27. As long as it's more than, I think it's 22 or 21. And then down here we've got the other five. So, with that all done, I think the last thing to do is start placing the doors. So, I'm just going to go back and watch Tango's video again and just refresh myself here, and then we'll come back and I'll show you how to make these doors stack on top of each other. Okay, so we're back here. And I just checked the video again, and yes, I did forget some stuff, which I'll show you down there in a minute. But this is the central area that all these guys are going to fall down. They're going to make their way, they can spawn all the way over here, they'll drop down and make their way over. So that should be fine. Now if we go down here and have a little look, this is something that I completely forgot about. This is where our iron golems are going to fall. They're going to land on top of these hoppers, and there's going to be a lava blade here which will kill them. And below that we're going to have our storage room, which is going to be in here for all the iron. And the storage room I've had in mind, well, I haven't really planned it yet, but we'll probably have chests four blocks high all the way around in a bit of a circle or a hall shape. And the other thing which is very important to this whole system is this little guy here. Now this is a filter, and if we what am I doing? Oops. So this is a filter for these poppies here. And you can just hear that hopper going at the moment. Sorry, not a hopper, it's a dropper. And now you can't. Now you can. Now you can't. So that's where our floor level's going to be. And I purposefully put this all the way down the bottom here so I couldn't hear it. So there is a little dropper here that shoots out the poppies, and the poppies get fired into this portal, and that will actually keep this chunk and this whole farm processing entities. So that is very important, and we can actually light this now, and each time a poppy gets spat into the portal, it will keep it going for about 60 seconds or so, as far as I'm aware. Correct me if I'm wrong. Alright, so with that now running, we are actually able to start doing the doors. So the doors are a bit tricky, and I'm just going to gather my things and we'll have a look at how to put these
doors down to create our villages that we're all going to stack on top of each other. Okay guys, here we are. We're ready to place some doors. Now, I went ahead and placed this polished andesite instead of the glowstone because you can't place doors on glowstone. Oh, so I placed a door there. That wasn't on the glowstone though. There we go. Can't place on glowstone. So, the first thing I need to do is find north, which is... ooh, that way. And we want to go over to this block here. This is my central line. And we put on a door right there. And that automatically creates a village. These guys here and these guys here both detect this door. We've got sunlight directly above it. That is a village already. And the central point of this village is this block right here. This is where we want the center of all the villages to be, and the golems will spawn and fall down through this center line. Now, the trick is we have to make a village here, one here, one here, one here, one here, and make sure that they're all separate villages, so 16 separate villages. Now, if I was to put another door here, these two doors are actually part of the same village, right there. So, that's no good. We can't do that. That won't work. So there's a special sequence that we have to do here. So if you can imagine, the center of this village here is right here. Now, the village's center is determined by the center point of all the doors in that village. So by placing another door over this side, we actually move the center point from this block over to, which one was it? I think this block. So the village center point is a little bit further away. And now if we were to place a door over there at the other end, it would be its own little village, and we can basically inch it closer and closer and closer until it's right here, and then we move that door out and this village goes back into line again. It's very difficult to explain, so I do suggest you go and watch Tango Tech's video, but this is basically how we're going to stack all these villages. So we've got one village here already, and the next thing is we're on, which line are we on? That's line 26, so line 27 is our next village. So we run all the way to the end here. All the way to the end, and this is far enough away that this door that I place now won't join that first village. So there's 20... was it 26 we're after? Okay, we're on 26, so let's do 27. Place a door here. Now it takes approximately 6 seconds for a villager to detect the door and know that it has sunlight and all the rest of it. So we are just going to wait for that to happen, and that way this door will be recognized. And while we're doing that, we're just going to fill these blocks in with cobble to make sure that I know where I'm up to. Once that door's been recognized, we come over to this side, and this time we're a little bit closer. And again, we want to be on 26, we've done, so we'll get rid of that. 27. I'm just looking at the Z coordinate there. Place another door here. And when that door gets recognized, the center of the village will move from this door over here to around about here somewhere in the middle of those two doors. And once that has happened, and we know that that's happened, we can come back here and we can now knock out this door, the first one we placed. And when we go back here, the center point of the village moves from about here somewhere all the way down to the next available door, which means the center point is here. So then we go down a little bit further. Again, with all these marked lines, that's the first one we made. We'll put another door here. And so on and so forth, and it repeats. So this village is now, the center point has moved from here over to between that door, which is about here somewhere. And once that's been detected, we can then go back and we can remove that door. And we could put a block there. And that means the village is now centered here. And basically we're just going to keep going all the way, all the way, all the way, until we get all the villages running along the center here. Once we get that village all the way to here, we can actually then break this door, which will move this village center to here again, and these will be all perfectly lined up. So it's going to take quite some time because you have to wait that 6 seconds, so I'm going to try and do all this and we'll be right back. Okay, next thing is, now that we have all our villages centered, we have to give them at least 11 doors each. So we need to slowly build up our doors all the way out until we have 11, And then we need to move the center point. Leave the center point where it is and move the doors out under cover here so that the iron golems can spawn in this area. So for my situation, I'm down facing the north side on the east side, so northeast, and we're just going to start placing doors down the row like this, all the way to the end, and then we're going to go back up to the top again, and we're going to place doors like so, down the row like this, and we're going to do this a few times until we get just enough doors out of the area. Okay guys, so I've got all the doors placed. That is 16 villages with 33 doors each. And the doors go all the way out to here. And now what we want to do is we want to actually knock out these middle ones. So what we've been doing there is we've been putting a door row on each side sequentially. And again, slowly moving that center point and then going in between, keeping it balanced. The doors out wider and wider and wider. The center point still remains here. And then now we've done that. Watch it, Enderman. Now we've done that, we can get rid of these extra doors, and this will be our spawning area right in the middle. Okay, so I cleared out the doors in the middle, and I should have checked it earlier, but I checked my MBT Explorer to see how it was going, and we've got some issues. There is one village in here at the moment with about 100 doors assigned to it, and all the rest have about 4 or 5 doors. So, that in short means I've made a mistake somewhere, and I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to fix it. Hopefully I don't have to do this whole thing all over again, but it may be the case. So I'm just going to have a quick little play with an idea that I had and see if that works, and then we'll come right back. And there's the culprit. I forgot to get rid of these blocks right here. In that case, my little idea won't work. I'm going to have to do all that all over again. Okay, see you in another couple of hours.
Yeah, I've had enough, guys. We've got another problem. I've just finished redoing all these doors, and my NBT Explorer also says I've got a wrong system going on here. There's something wrong. I've already started breaking down the doors. I had a good think about what I was possibly doing wrong, and I thought about, well, how is this any different to what Tango Tech is doing? And then it struck me, I'm underground, which, you know, I thought I had a contingency for everything I needed to being underground, but in Tango's tutorial, he talks about leaving skyblock access here, and here, and that's all. Because his farm is built in the sky, he didn't talk about this section. Now, I just assumed that one block would be enough, but it's actually not. So, if we have a look here, let's see, where are we? Let's use this as a reference. So, doors will check 5 blocks on either side of them to see what the light level is in a particular block, to work out what's inside and what's outside. So if we start from here, 5 blocks to our right would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So out of those 5 blocks, one of them has sky access. And then if we go on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that also has sky access. So this row in the middle, where was it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This row right here, right in here, this whole row is actually not valid village doors because they have the same number of sky blocks on this side as they do on this side. So that is a problem. And let's see, how far can we go here? So if we take this one as an example and we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this row of doors, which we looked at before. So let's look at, say, these ones here. So the next one over, let's go from this door. So that's that door there. So 1,
two, three, four, five. So here there's one block of sky. And where were we? This door here. Sorry, hang on. This door here. One, two, three, four, five. Yeah. Alright, so this door. One, two, three, four, five. So that one's actually okay. And I imagine these ones here are okay as well. So that row of doors is no good. Let's see what about this side. I think this side's got a few more problems than the other. So this one, Tango said to leave two blocks, but again, didn't mention anything about here because he was building in the sky. So if I measure this one as well, so one, two, three, four, five. So that block there. So this door here. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, so that one's actually okay. Let's go another one over. So one, two, three, four, five. So this door. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, so that row there, this row, has no sky access at all for either of these. So again, that's not going to work. So that row there is actually no good. Now maybe that's because we've got the two rows here. Maybe that needs to be another row of sky blocks. Anyway, I'll have to work this out and come back and rebuild it. But for now, I've had more than enough of placing doors. I've placed way too many doors. So, yeah, unfortunately we didn't get the iron farm working, but we will soon. I can feel it. We can do it very soon once I sort out this skyblock issue. But, anyway, that'll about do it for today's episode. Hopefully when we come back next time we'll have something to show for it. But thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time. ¶¶